Ave, Frank Zhang, son of Mars.
He'd removed his helmet, revealing a babyish face that didn't go with his military haircut or his big, burly frame. He looked like a cuddly koala bear with muscles.
Shortly after you were born, a woman appeared at the fire. She told your mother, "He will close the circle. He will return your family to its roots and bring you great honor. He will be the strongest of your clan and the greatest. But the fates have decreed he will also be the most vulnerable. As soon as that piece of tinder is consumed, your son is destined to die."
My mom was a captain. She saved some soldiers who were pinned down by enemy fire. She didn't make it. The funeral was right before I came down here. His first month at camp was spent knocking over rows of weapons, breaking chariots, and tripping entire cohorts as they marched. Nothing he planned ever went right. He always managed to break, ruin, burn, sit on, or knock over something important. Frank figured Reyna was regretting her decision to let him join. Every day he woke up wondering if the stick would somehow catch fire and burn. His new medals felt cold against his chest. The Centurion's Crescent, the Mural Crown. He should have been proud of them, but he felt like he'd only gotten them because his dad had bullied Reyna. Frank didn't know how his friends could stand to be around him. He was no hero. He was a lactose intolerant klutz.
"You want to know why Juno spared you, Frank? Why that piece of wood didn't burn yet? It's because you've got a role to play. Duty, sacrifice. They mean something."
Frank was so disgusted he could hardly speak. This was his father? Sure, Frank understood about his mom being a hero, but she'd left him alone. That wasn't fair.
"Fair. Is it fair that your life will burn so short and bright? Was it fair when I guided your mother to the underworld? No. And yet, it was her time. There is no fairness in death."
Frank understood what he had to do to break those chains. Mars had warned him. He'd explained why he loved Emily Zhang so much.
"She always put her duty first, ahead of everything. Even her life."
Now it was Frank's turn. His mother's sacrifice medal felt warm in his pocket. He finally understood his mother's choice. He got what Mars had been trying to tell him. In Frank's chest, a hard knot of anger and resentment finally began to dissolve. He understood why his mother never came home. Some things were worth dying for. Frank had heard about people's lives flashing before their eyes, but now he experienced it literally.
"Frank, you are a leader. We need you."
"Always remember, Frank, you can be anything."
He thought he understood his powers at last. Something about watching the firewood burn, smelling the acrid smoke of his own life, had made him feel strangely confident.
"Is it fair your life burns so short and bright?"
"No such thing is fair. If I'm going to burn, it might as well be bright."
He changed shape, became an elephant, a dragon, a lion. And each transformation seemed to clear his lungs, giving him a fresh burst of energy. Yes, the smallest bit of fire might kill him, but he'd also survived some impossible things and made his dad proud. Frank had decided that whatever his fate was, he wouldn't worry about it. He would just do the best he could to help his friends.
"Come on! You want to know what Frank Zhang is worth? Come on!"
Frank's whole bearing had changed. He'd grown into his weight. No one could call him pudgy or cuddly anymore. His shoulders had broadened. He walked with more confidence. He was a leader of the Legion now, doing what he was born to do, fighting the enemies of Rome, upholding its legacy, protecting the lives of his friends and comrades. He was Praetor Frank Zhang.
"You did great, Frank. It's been an honor."
"Happy late birthday, kid."